Final report of the commercial starship Nostromo. Third officer reporting. The other members of the crew. Kane, Lambert, Parker, Brett, Ash, and Captain Dallas are dead. Cargo and ship destroyed. I should reach the frontier in about 6 weeks. With a little luck, the network will pick me up. This is Ripley, last survivor of the Nostromo, signing off.
I'm Samuels. I work for the company. It's about your mother. We think we may have found her, Amanda. A commercial vessel, the Anisadora, has recovered what we believe to be the flight recorder unit of the Nostromo.
Where?
Zeta Reticula.
What did it tell you?
We don't know. The unit was taken to Sevastopol Station. It's proprietorial material, so the company wants it to be collected as soon as possible. Sevastopol's a supply depot in the region. It's a permanent freeport facility.
I know what it is.
Transit's arranged. There's a courier ship called the Torrens heading out that way in 2 days. We're going to travel out.
We?
Me and another exec. And you, if you're willing. Look, Ripley, when this job came across my desk, I read the case history. I know while you're working in the region where she went missing. You're still looking, aren't you? I've been cleared to offer you a place on the Torrens if you want to come along. Maybe there'll be some closure for you.
Taylor, good morning.
Ripley, it's certainly not good. I very much doubt it's morning either. Sorry. I feel like death. I don't know how you people put up with hypersleep regularly.
You get used to it.
I don't do long haul very often. Most legal execs don't travel further than the coffee machine.
I'm surprised Weyland-Yutani felt the need to send legal at all.
The loss of the Nostromo and its cargo cost the company a lot of money. It's important we find out what happened. If I can close the case with a conclusive accident report, it'll look great with my superiors. I'm sorry. That was insensitive. I realize your mother has been missing for 15 years and you...
It's okay. We'll both get what we want, right?
Have you seen Samuels? He's probably been up for hours.
I'll catch up with him.
Thank you. Ripley.
Samuels, did you wake up early?
Well, I don't really need as much sleep as the rest of you. I was just inspecting the Torrens facilities, a well-maintained ship. I realize it's a very similar model to...
The Nostromo?
Yes, M-class. A later pattern, but close in spec.
I've worked engineering jobs on ships like this.
Of course. Is Taylor up yet? She's not a seasoned traveler. Hypersleep may have been punishing for her.
We talked. She seems nervous.
I hadn't noticed. She's a skilled executive, though. Should help us with any legal issues we might encounter.
All personnel to the bridge, approaching Sevastopol Station.
Looks like we're up.
Hope you all had a restful journey.
The Torrens is in very good order for an old M-class, Captain.
She was a wreck when I bought her. Took a few years and a lot of contracts to refit. She pays for herself now.
You said we're approaching Sevastopol Station. Are we docking?
I believe your contact is Marshal Waits, is that right? I'll hail Sevastopol and arrange boarding with him.
Good. Let's get this done.
Don't worry, Miss Taylor. Routine. In and out. Connor, how are we doing?
SMG loaded and calibrated. Approach vector locked.
Prep comms so I can say hello.
Channel open, Captain.
Does everyone have their briefing document?
You can watch the approach on the monitors.
Can we see it?
Switch to monitors. Sevastopol Station.
Is that damage?
It looks like damage.
Punch up 74, tight angle.
Looks like the dry dock bay is screwed.
I can't bring the Torrens into that.
This is the commercial vessel Torrens out of St. Clair, registration number MSV7760, calling Sevastopol Traffic Control. We're carrying three passengers on a Wayland.
Yutani Bond, you're holding the Nostromo Flight Recorder Unit. We request immediate permission to transfer the passengers port side over. Marshal, this is the Torrens. Say again. The station's comms seem pretty screwed up, so I fitted Samuel's suit with a radio booster. I can only keep the Torrens in transit for 24 hours.
You'll have heard from us by then.
Safe trip.
Stand by. My contract doesn't cover bloody spacewalks. It's the only option, and it's perfectly safe if you do what I tell you. Depressurizer. Oh, fuck. Hating this. Just shadow me, Taylor. You too, Samuels.
Affirmative.
What the fuck happened here?
good tip. Just keep moving!
Taylor Ripley, hold on!
Taylor! Respond! Anybody!
compromised. Proceed to the nearest Marshall checkpoint and stand by while orbital stabilizers realign.
This'll help. long time ago, when the world was much younger than it is now, people told and believed a great many wonderful stories about wonderful things which neither you nor I have ever seen. Talked about a mighty being called Jupiter or Zeus, who was the king of the sky and the earth, and they said he sat most of the time amid the clouds on top of a very high mountain, where he could look down and see everything that was going on in the earth and beneath. He had to ride on the storm clouds and hurl burning thunderbolts right and left among the trees and rocks, and he was so very, very mighty that when he nodded, the earth quaked. The mountains trembled in smoke, the sky grew black, and the sun hit his face. Jupiter had two brothers, both of them terrible fellows, but not nearly so great as himself. The name of one was Neptune, or Poseidon, and he was king of the sea. He had a glittering golden palace far down in the deep sea caves, where the fishes live and the red coral grows. And whenever he was angry, the waves would rise mountain high, the storm winds would howl fearfully, and the sea would try to break over the land. And men called him the Shaker of the Earth. The other brother of Jupiter was a sad, pale-faced being, whose kingdom was underneath the earth, where the sun never shone, where there was darkness and weeping and sorrow. All the time. His name was Pluto, and his country was called the Lower World, the Land of Shadows, or Hades. It said that whenever anyone died, Pluto would send his messenger, or shadow leader, to carry one down into the Cheerless Kingdom. And for that reason, they never spoke well of him, but thought only of him as the enemy of life. Many other of mighty beings lived with Jupiter amid the clouds on the mountaintop. So many I can name very few only. There was Venus, queen of love and beauty, who was fairer by far than any woman you and I has ever seen. There was Athena, or Minerva, the queen of the air, who gave people wisdom and taught them how to do many useful things. There was Juno, the queen of the earth and sky, who sat at the right hand of Jupiter and gave all kinds of advice. There was Mars, the great warrior, whose delight was in the din of battle. Mercury, the swift messenger, who had wings on his cap and shoes, and who flew from place to place, like the summer clouds when they are driven forth before the wind. There was Vulcan, a skillful blacksmith, who had his forge in a burning mountain, and wrought many wonderful things of iron and copper and gold. And besides these, there were many about whom you can learn by and by, and about whom men told strange and beautiful stories. They lived in a glittering golden mansion, high above the clouds. So high indeed that the eyes of men could never see them, that they could look down and see what men were doing. And of all these mighty folk, Jupiter was by far the mightiest.
Thank you. Hello? Anyone here?
Harris, Turner, get back here now. We have a track somewhere in engineering. Lock the terminal down, kill the power, and don't forget your reports. Make them thorough. We're gonna need our paperwork to be bulletproof when this shit's over. Wait's up.
the hell happened here?
Thank you. Jones, today's update. After numerous demands, Marshal Waits finally called a public meeting to address the rumors that have been circulating on Sevastopol. But instead of the answers we wanted, he continued to be evasive, and after only a few minutes, he and his team were pelted by projectiles from an angry crowd. A gun was fired, there was panic, and now Waits and what's left of his team are forcibly ejecting us from the terminal. Feels like we're on our own now. Ruya Jones, today's update. After numerous demands, Marshal Waits finally called a public meeting to address the rumors that have been circulating on Sevastopol. But instead of the answers we wanted, he continued to be evasive, and after only a few minutes, he and his team were pelted by projectiles from an angry crowd. A gun was fired, there was panic, and now Waits and what's left of his team are forcibly ejecting us from the terminal. Feels like we're on our own now. Ruya Jones, today's update. After numerous demands, Marshal Waits finally called a public meeting to address the rumors that have been circulating on Sevastopol. But instead of the answers we wanted, he continued to be evasive, and after only a few minutes, he and his team were pelted by projectiles from an angry crowd. A gun was fired, there was panic, and now Waits and what's left of his team are forcibly ejecting us from the terminal. Feels like we're on our own now.
This whole damn place is falling apart.
Thank you.
That's gotta be the exit up ahead.
It's Turner. Gotta deal with that wasted asshole again. This time he nearly wrecked the door with a maintenance jack. Guess he figures it's safe here. Wants to lock himself in. Screw him. We got too much to worry about without babysitting drunks. Anyway, I threw him in the evidence lockup. Let the son of a bitch sleep it off. Rares, it's Turner. Gotta deal with that wasted asshole again. This time he nearly wrecked the door with a maintenance jack. Guess he figures it's safe here. Wants to lock himself in. Screw him. We got too much to worry about without babysitting drunks. Anyway, I threw him in the evidence lockup. Let the son of a bitch sleep it off.
this more than you do.
Interview subject. Heist. Did I say that right? Heist? Look, if you can't even tell me your name, we're gonna be here a hell of a long time. I just wanna know about your boss. He's got you all into a lot of trouble. Someone's gonna be accountable. I'm gonna make damn sure someone's accountable. No? Tough guy, huh? Turner, turn off the tape. Maybe our friend here is just shy.